Hello viewers, welcome to the session on tourism. Today we are going to discuss the topic on concepts of entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is one of the four mainstream of economic factors: land, labor, capital and entrepreneurship. It is a dynamic activity which helps the entrepreneur to bring changes in the process of production, innovation in production, new usage of materials, creator of market who can enlarge and enrich the product. It is something where the work is executed in a planned and rational manner to achieve desired goals. Entrepreneur is an economic person who plays a very important role in the economic development of a country. The steady and positive growth in the economic levels depends mainly on entrepreneurs. He is an individual with knowledge, skills, initiative, drive and spirit of innovation who aims at achieving goals. He identifies the opportunities and seizes opportunities for economic benefits. Entrepreneurship is one of the most important input in the economic development of any country or region. He is an economic agent for a change before 17th century. The term entrepreneur was used to describe both an action and a person who managed large production projects. During the 17th century, a direct link between the risk and entrepreneurship was established. During this period, a person who entered into a contractual agreement with government to perform a service or to supply the stipulated product by taking the risk was called an entrepreneur. Definition: the word entrepreneur is derived from the French verb entreprendre, which means to undertake. During 16th century, the Frenchmen who organized and led military expedition were called or referred to as entrepreneurs. In the beginning of 18th century, Mr. Richard Cantillon, a French economist, used the term entrepreneur to a business. According to him, entrepreneur means one who takes the risk of starting a new business or organization or introducing a new idea, product or service to the society. According to J.B. Say, an entrepreneur is an economic agent who unites all means of production, that is, land of one, the labor of another and the capital from the third, and produces a product. After selling the product in the market, he pays the rent for the land, wages to labor, interest on capital invested, and the leftout or surplus will be his share of profit. Mr. Jean Baptiste defines an entrepreneur is basically an organizer. He is a person who combines the land, labor, and capital belonging to others and brings out a product demanded by the users. He emphasizes the function of coordination, organization, and supervision for an entrepreneur. Thus, an entrepreneur is an organizer and a speculator of a business enterprise. Mr. Joseph A. Scumpeter defines the entrepreneur in an advanced society is an individual who introduces something new in the economy. He advocates that only entrepreneurs can bring dynamic changes by instituting new combinations of production, that is, innovation, new combination of factors of production may occur in any one of five forms. Point number one, introduction of new product in the market. Point number two, the institution of a new production technology. Point number three, the opening of a new market into which a specific product has not previously entered. Point number four, the discovery of a new source of supply of raw materials. And Point number 5, carrying out of the new form of organization of any business. According to him, an inventor is one who discovers new methods and new materials, whereas an innovator is the one who utilizes the inventions to discover something new by making new combinations. During 20th century, the word entrepreneur gained more importance, and the functions of the entrepreneur was to reform or revolutionize the pattern of production by exploring inventions or more generally an untried technological method of producing new commodity. Thus, he will create a demand for the new product. The concept of innovation and newness is an integral part of an entrepreneur. The newness can consist of anything from a new product to a new organizational structure. The economic growth rate depends to a great extent on the activities of an entrepreneur. The new Encyclopedia Britannica considers an entrepreneur as an individual who bears the risk of operating business in the face of uncertainty about the future conditions. Mr. Karl Marx, leading economist of all schools, has emphasized the contribution of entrepreneurs to development of economy. Benjamin Higgins defines entrepreneurs as the function of seeing investment and production opportunities, organizing an enterprise to undertake a new production process, raising capital, arranging for the supply of raw materials, hiring labor, finding a suitable location, and combining these factors of production into a going concern, introducing a new technique and commodities, discovering new source of natural resources, and selecting top managers for day-to-day operations. An entrepreneur is a dynamic person who creates wealth for others as well as finds better ways to utilize resources. Peter F. Drucker defines entrepreneurship as neither a science nor an art. It is a practice. It has a knowledge base. Knowledge in entrepreneurship is a means to an end. Indeed, what constitutes knowledge in practice is largely defined by the ends, that is, by the practice. V.R. Gayakwad says entrepreneurship connotes innovativeness, an urge to take risk in face of uncertainties, and an institution, that is, a capacity of seeing things in a way which afterwards proves to be true. H.N. Pathak defines entrepreneurship as an entrepreneurship involves a wide range of areas on which a series of discussions are required, which can be grouped into three categories: a perception of an opportunity, organizing an industrial unit, and running the industrial unit as a profitable going and growing concern. Thus, entrepreneurship is the dynamic process of creating something new with value by devoting the necessary time and effort, assuming the accompanying financial, physical, and social risk, and receiving the resulting rewards of monetary and personal satisfaction. Entrepreneurship is more often used for starting and running one's own business. He is a person who is highly determined, creative, result-oriented, well in tune with the end, and is also to translate the vision into business. Entrepreneurs are the visionaries who have better capacity to judge the things to come. Thus, their role becomes more calculated than it appears to be. Importance of entrepreneurship for the Indian economy. India is a developing country with a lot of socio-economic political problems. entrepreneurship can play an important role not only in the industrial sector of a country, but in the farm and service sector also. Entrepreneurship is an intangible factor in the moving force, and developing is the only end or final objective which is ever changing. India has many problems such as illiteracy, overpopulation, unemployment, underemployment, poverty, problem of rural areas, urban areas, waste management, concentration of economic power, political power, problem of large-scale industries, etc. To overcome above said problems, entrepreneurship is the only remedy from which India can become a developed country by 2020 to fulfill the dream of late Dr.
A.P.J. Abdul Kalam,
the father of nation,
Mahatma Gandhi ji,
advocated. Development of villages in India leads to the development of country. Government has to encourage small,
tiny,
home, medium-scale industries which will help the development of rural areas. Entrepreneurship is growing very fast now. The factors which slow down the progress in India and also the success of entrepreneurship are inadequate infrastructural facilities, shortage of capital, technical know-how, poor transport system, absence of cheap and good quality raw materials, shortage of power and government support. Now, the government is taking significant means and steps to encourage entrepreneurship. As entrepreneurship is the only solution to various problems of developing countries like India. The skills of entrepreneurship tells how to turn an ordinary business organization into a big entrepreneurial organization. The working people should be trained to detect the opportunities, pursue the opportunities and reward, and to learn lessons from the consequences of failures. It is said that an economy is the effect in which entrepreneurship is the cause. Entrepreneurial growth.
Jin Tin
and A.H. Cole said, "No entrepreneur, no development." What a wonderful note. It shows the importance of entrepreneurs. Today, human capital, his skill and knowledge is more valued than just financial capital. The economic advancement of a country depends on availability of entrepreneurial talents in adequate quantity. Economic incentives are the main drive for entrepreneurship. Today, there is shortage of rational entrepreneurial talent which can be developed with proper training and motivation. The developing countries, including India, are giving much importance for development of good and positive entrepreneurship. As technology improves, it results in competition which will help in reduction of price and good quality product or better services. It will also help for specialization, good and safe transport, very efficient communication, educated, skilled labor force, helps to promote the rapid development of industries. A rapid and balanced economic development and expansion of opportunities for employment as well as self-employment are the basic objectives of developmental planning. Economic development is primarily related to impulse of social change, reflecting the developmental usage for self-respect, self-help and self-reliance. Entrepreneurial talent can be developed with proper training and motivation. The developing countries are giving much importance for development of entrepreneurship. Industrialization results from the interaction of technological change, economic development, essentially means a process of upward change. Thus, the per capita income of a country increases over a long period of time. David Ricardo identifies only three factors of production, namely machinery, capital, and labor, among which the entire produce is distributed as rent, profit, and wages respectively. Profit leads to savings of wealth, which ultimately goes to the capital formation. Factors influencing entrepreneurial growth. The factors affecting the growth of entrepreneurial is classified into two categories, namely economic factors and non-economic factors. Economic factors include capital, labor, raw material, and market. Point number one, capital. If sufficient money is there, then everything is right. The entire world is behind money. Capital is the most important prerequisite to establish any enterprise. Availability of capital facilitates the entrepreneur to bring together the other factors of production and can manufacture the goods. Thus, capital is regarded as the lubricant to the process of production. Whenever input of capital increases, naturally the output or sales increases. Thus, profit also goes up, which leads to capital formation. Availability of capital facilitates mobility of men and materials. Point number two, the labor. Getting skilled and quality labor is very difficult. Cheap labor may not be having quality. We have to replace labor as far as possible with new technology. If possible, outsource the labor. If once we get good, trustable labor, preserve them. We have to follow all labor laws. Point number three, raw materials. Availability of good quality and quantity of raw material is very essential. Nature of industrial establishment and technological innovations encourage the development of entrepreneurship. Point number four, market. First, we should try to satisfy the needs of the customers by supplying quality product at a competitive price. Then, the market should be enlarged and enriched. Good market constitutes an essential prerequisite for the entrepreneurial growth. Non-economical factors. There are a number of non-economic factors which have a direct impact on the growth of entrepreneurship. There are many sociological and psychological factors or conditions which are also taken into account. Point number one, sociological conditions. According to sociologists, social conditions and culture values are responsible for the emergence of entrepreneurship. A set of standard social norms and values, degree of approval or disapproval of the entrepreneurial behavior, family background, quality of education, technological knowledge, etc., have direct relation on the growth of entrepreneurship. Point number two, psychological conditions. Entrepreneurship is most likely to emerge when a society has sufficient supply of individuals possessing particular psychological characteristics. Entrepreneurs are primarily motivated by a strong will power to achieve something new. These classes of entrepreneurs have the capacity to withstand social opposition. Need achievement is the major determinant of entrepreneurship. Impact of achievement, motivation, and training program influence the development of entrepreneurship. Individuals with high achievement tend to take interest in situations of high risk, desire for responsibility, and concrete measure of task performance. Point number 3, political support or government support. The government can encourage entrepreneurship by creating basic infrastructure facilities, service and giving a number of incentives. Government support is very essential for the entrepreneurs, and government can shape and motivate positive entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurship in India. The economic need forces people to become entrepreneurs, but in India, we have got shortage of positive entrepreneurs due to different reasons. Systematic and sustained efforts are to be made to identify and foster persons having entrepreneurial qualities in developing economies like India. Entrepreneurship development acquires importance for the following reasons. Point number 1, to speed up the pace of economic development. Point number 2, to prepare a broad framework for the balanced development of all regions. Point number 3, long-term plan to solve the problem of unemployment and underemployment. Point number 4, directing the available resources to the
non-traditional
areas of investment. Point number 5, optimum utilization of natural resources and productivity in all fields to be achieved. Point number 6, reducing the gap between planning and its execution. Point number 7, red tapism and corruption. Characteristics of an entrepreneur. Point number 1, he is a result-oriented person who normally takes high risk and enjoy his role and try to achieve it. Point number 2, he will have strong and firm determination and commitment towards his job and goal. Point number 3, to achieve the goals and objectives, he will sacrifice his personal life and pleasure. Point number 4, he works to gain personal satisfaction, but not for the monetary award, but money comes to him. Point number 5, entrepreneurs are the best thinkers, doers, planners, dreamers and workers. Point number 6, entrepreneurs have high level of skill, knowledge and imagination. Point number 7, entrepreneurs are the great visionaries who can foresee the future and work accordingly. Point number 8, he should have got good humanity because he has to maintain good human relation with his employees and also with his suppliers and customers. Point number 9, he should possess good command on the communication skill and language. Point number 10, he should be good motivator and have self-confidence. Qualities required to become a successful entrepreneur. Point number 1, risk bearer. He takes the risk, but he will not gamble or avoid risk. Point number 2, creative. He has got creativity with great imagination. Point number 3, clear goals. His goals and objectives are very clear and there will be no second thought. He knows the path or way in which he has to move to achieve the desired goals. Point number 4, opportunity explorer. He leaves no stone unturned. He makes use of every possible opportunity to reach his objectives. Point number 5, motivation. The entrepreneur should be good motivator and administrator, and he knows the skills of how to get the things done and to reach his goal. Point number 6, flexibility. A good entrepreneur will always take decisions depending on the existing situations. He will not even mind to revise his decision to reach the goals. Point number 7, great planner. An entrepreneur is a good planner. He has to plan his business strategy with great vision and depending on ground reality. Point number 8, organizing ability. he should have skill to arrange men, material, money and other required resources in a very short time. Point number 9, attitude. He should always have a positive, rational attitude. He should always accept any change with required reasons. Number 10, common welfare. The entrepreneur should work for common or general purpose. Point number 11, cool and calm. He will be working with a lot of innovations which attract physical and emotional stress. He has to maintain coolness in spite of his tensions. Point number 12, confidence. He should have got confidence in his work and clear in objectives. He should know his strong and weak points and work on long-term requirements. Difference between the entrepreneur and a manager. The entrepreneur and manager appears to be same, but the following differences can be found out between them. Point number 1, objective or aim. Entrepreneur ventures by noting up an enterprise. He understands his venture is for his personal gratification, whereas the manager will render his service in an organization which has already been established. Point number 2, value. The entrepreneur is the owner of the enterprise and the manager is an employee of an enterprise. Risk. Entrepreneur is the owner, he bears all the risk and uncertainty involved in running the organization. Whereas a manager is a servant and therefore he will not take any risk. Reward. Entrepreneur gets a high or all profits earned by the organization, but it is uncertain. Whereas a manager gets a fixed amount of salary irrespective of company's result. Research or innovation. Entrepreneur always tries to find new methods and means to satisfy his customers with good quality and at competitive prices. Whereas a manager is normally an executive who plans on the execution of the work. Qualification. An entrepreneur, in addition to the normal education, he will be having high achievement motives and foresight, whereas the manager is having a university qualification and experience. So, to conclude this chapter, I hope you have understood the importance of entrepreneur, who plays a very important role in the development of Indian economy in all the areas. Thank you very much for viewing this episode.